nice to have you. Come on over.
Thank you.
Take a chair over there. I'll be here.
Okay.
You bet.
Congressman, this is Colton Powell.
Hi, Congressman. Nice to see you.
How are you, Bob?
Nice to see you.
Glad to see you.
NSC Director.
Yes, sir.
Well, I guess you've got the others here. Well, I'm looking forward to this because I understand your position on national security, national defense is much the same.
Well, I'm very strong on national defense. I always have been. I've always felt like it was an absolute must.
And is it right that you also support a line item veto?
That's correct. I want you to know I got a lot of heat from a lot of Democrats.
Well, welcome aboard. Well, I had it for 8 years as a governor of California.
Did you?
And there are 43 governors, you know, that have that.
Yes.
I just, coming here, I miss that more than anything.
Well, I think the time's come because if we're serious about balancing the budget and solving a lot of these other problems, and I think we've diluted the authority of the presidency too much by the courts and Congress and the bureaucracy over the years, and it's time to restore some. We ought to do it now.
I like that. Now, that's why I wanted to talk to you about the freedom fighters. I don't know how much you know or what it is about that. We're convinced that their pressure is what has brought the Sandinistas for the first time to be willing to talk about a peace plan, negotiate. We, for 7 years, have been trying to bring that about on our own. We had a representative down there, and we could get the freedom fighters to agree to lay down their arms and talk. We never could get the Sandinistas to. But now with them doing this, we believe that that little gift that we're going to sequester, you understand, I think, the program, 36 million,
yes.
3.6 of that is going to be put in escrow, and that's for weapons. The others are all for food and medicine and things like that. But if they get together and cease fire, then the weapons will stay there. They won't go to the food and medicine. If they don't, and if the Sandinistas are still behaving as they have been in the past, then we release the weapons to the freedom fighters. I'm going to ask Colton to tell you more about the program there.
Congressman, you and I have something in common that you know where Fort Campbell, Kentucky is.
Right down the road from you.
Listen, I heard you had the flu bug.
I had the good flu bug last week, and some people said, did you feel like you've returned from the walking dead? No, I said crawling dead from the bed to the bathroom and back to bed. Before we get started, I just want to hand this to you. It's the only copy that I'm going to send over here. I'm not sure that you'll have time to read it, but it's a report on a trip that I just got back from the South Pacific with emphasis on Philippines, Australia, and New Zealand. And the part that you might be interested in is with the Philippines. I'm very much concerned about things over there. Had a meeting with Admiral Crow yesterday. And there are some problems that I'm sure you know about. That's going to highlight some of the things that we saw over there. We had a nice visit with Mrs. Aquino. What a gracious lady, great lady she is. We've got her hands full. We've got to do more than what we've done, I think, over there with our base problems and everything else. But at least it's a summary, and that's a White House copy. And it just came off the press, and I said, I'll hand it to the president myself.
Well,
thanks for the
day. Hi, how are you? I think pretty good for a right guard. 8 years in the line.
Well, come on in.
Thank you.
Know everybody.
Thank you.
Sure
we
do.
Cole Powell, nice to see you.
Good to meet you, Tom. Good.
Hi, Ken.
How are you?
Good, Tom. How are you doing?
Thank you. The level, and I did because my hand was so cold. I got hurt 10 minutes later. Well, listen, it's good of you to come down. I understand one of your children is ill. I hope nothing serious.
Nothing serious that the good people at the Children's Hospital haven't been able to help considerably. We discovered that she was born with neither leg is going up into either socket, and the sockets in our hips hadn't formed, but through traction and major surgery, yeah, it's come along very well. So science has taken her to a point where I think she'll be pretty much all right. Thank you for asking.
Is this your daughter you're talking about?
Yes. Yes. She's a spunky little girl. She's not quite 2 years old yet, but she's making a pretty good recovery. Matter of fact, I was incognito to a couple of phone calls, I think, emanating from this office yesterday because I was in transit, brought her down to see the doctor and back. So it's good to be with you today.
Well, now, you kind of touched a nerve with me also because I understand that you're on service in Vietnam and all. I don't know that you're aware yet, but I have just signed letters to the leadership up on the hill. Change the policy in which I am going to make the deal.
How are you? You got a nice group of people here to see us.
They're coming right here.
Stan Scott.
President, how are you, sir?
Hello there.
Good seeing you, sir.
Good to see you.
Yes, sir. Right. Glad to be here.
Stan worked
for us.
Well, it's good to see you again.
Mr. President, John Calhoun.
Hello there.
Mr. President Ford.
Well,
of course, you know Bob.
Mr. President, Bob on Mel. How about this time? Yeah. All right.
We're
going to
take a group.
Well, listen, it's a great pleasure to have you all back here. It's good to be able to say thank you for all that you've done. Progress that we've made because of you.
They go back a long way, Mr. President.
Yes, they do.
Clip worked for
25 years. LBJ.
President Kennedy.
Yeah.
John worked with President Foreman.
I may get it with the LBJ story or two.
That's all right. I'll trade
Well,
as long as you don't throw me some hard passes, that's okay. It. Yeah.
Right here. This is good.
Just squeeze it as much as we can. That's great. Okay, everybody's looking right here. Good. Okay, one more. Here we go. Thank you.
Well, I'm sorry I couldn't join that around the table session there to hear you more stories.
Yeah, great session, Mr. President, exchanging stories.
Well, one of my favorites has to do with him was out here on the South Lawn going for the helicopter. One of the agents told me they don't usually talk about things, but you know the press is always covering you. Well, Lyndon started for the wrong helicopter. And the agent stepped in and got in there and says, Mr. President, that's your helicopter over there.
This is it.
And Lyndon stopped and turned and he says, son, they're all mine.
That sounds like it.
And this one was one I thought it was the greatest prescription of all. He said that. He said one day, after some of the press attention, he said, if I went down and walked across the Potomac River on the surface of the water, the next day the press would report, President can't swim.
We were in here once,
and he had a console of the three television sets, and he said to some of us on the staff, while you are all reading the New York Times and the Washington Post, America's watching ABC, NBC.
Well, listen, just
a few mementos here or souvenirs of the office.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. President.
All right. Since you were all familiar
with this, you've
been here before. Thank you very much. Well, again, as I say, thank you for all that you've done, and I think great progress has been made.
And we need more sort of thing like this.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you very much, Mr. President.
That was a good spiral of all you threw this day, Mr. President.
I was entertained when I found out afterward that he was more nervous about whether he was going to catch it than I was.
Thank you
very much, Mr. President. I have an eagle, incidentally. Down for the gala. Okay. Very blessed to you.
Senator Tenskin.
Well, great group of women.
Nice to see you. Nice to see you. Thank you.
Hi, Glenn Cox.
Hello there.
Nice to meet
Thank you very much.
Clarissa Davis.
It's all up, brother.
Nice to see you. You didn't do anything too rough there.
No, I didn't.
All right.
Hilda Crooks.
Hello there.
It was great to climb to the top of the Capitol today.
Well, I haven't done that.
Zena Garris.
Open me sometime.
Well, nice to see you.
Hi, pleased to meet you.
Well, pleased to meet you.
Diana Golden.
Hi.
Hello there.
Nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you.
Connie Young.
Hello. Nice to see you.
Pam Schreiber.
Hey.
Check in on you.
Yep.
Kim Oden.
Hello there.
Lily White.
Hello.
Lynn St. James.
How do you do, Mr. President?
Hello there.
Thank you.
Denise Parker.
Hello there.
Stephanie Hightower.
Nice to meet you.
Terry Barnes.
Hello.
Dorothy Ritchie.
Nice to see you.
Deborah Anderson.
Nice to meet you.
Billy Jean King.
Excuse me, we have to get the press in here first because they want to get you first.
Forgive us.
You're going to let the camera plug in.
That's all right. We'll bring them in.
Billy Jean King.
How are you, Mr. President?
Carol
Mann. Hi. Hi, Mr. President. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Thank you.
And Jackie Joyner
Person. The others are going to make presentations first.
Oh,
okay.
On behalf of the Women's Sports Foundation and the Girls and Women's National Sports Day, this may not be appropriate in the White House, but how about on the ranch?
Just fine. And now and then I sneak around here without putting all of this on.
California, I know.
Yes.
One for Mrs. Reagan.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm going to reach across just for a second. This is a memory of the day, National Women's Sport Day, that you've helped us so much by having us here and meeting with us today. And all these athletes over here are range in age from 14 to 91. And they've competed all over the world for our country. And it's just a pleasure to have their names on this box and share this with you on National Women's Sport Day. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. I'm very pleased and proud to have this.
Great.
Now, this is the Flo Hyman Memorial Award, and Jackie Joyner Kersee, you who holds a world record, you've broken it, you are going to be the second recipient of this. We know that she was the captain of our Olympic volleyball team, two Olympics, and then her tragic death, but I'm very pleased and proud to be able to make this award to you. The heptathlon. That's the on a world record. Broken it.
Tight,
real tight.
Tight,
yeah.
Tight and short.
No, be tall. I wish I were tall.
I got cut off.
Thank you.
All right. Well, thank you.
We're going to do a photo behind the desk now with everyone. The press are going to leave and we'll do an official photo.
All right.
All right, guys.
You're not getting them all.
Okay, great. Everybody in here?
How did they get us all?
So real wide.
Wide body.
Well, listen, thank you all. So proud of everything, all that you have done. And I think you deserve a little note here that, don't quote me if you say it outside, because I don't want to make enemies. But this summer, when it was about 105 degrees, there was a very formal Marine affair here in Washington, and all of the Marines in full dress uniform. Seven of them passed out from the heat. None of them were the women. All males.
We can take the heat.
Well, it's wonderful to see you all to have you all here.
Thank you.
There's quite a collection of championships in here.
Got a lot to follow.
Yes. All right. Well, God bless you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Nice to be with all you guys.